Hey, what's going on, guys? Today I wanted to do a review on this new LG wash tower. It's a washer and dryer. It's combined in one, and it's just one unit that you can't separate. That's what's unique or different about it relative to the other options out there. Most other options, even if you can stack them, you can also separate them and have them side by side, where this one is together. And we're gonna get into the pros and cons here in a minute, and I'll kind of explain like the idea and thinking behind it, and then hopefully help you decide if it is a good washer and dryer for you to buy, or if you should go a different route. Okay, so as far as I can tell, there are three models. You could argue six, because they offer the same models, not only in electric, but in gas for the drying side. But if we eliminate that, there's three models. This is your basic model, and the difference between the basic model and one step up, as far as I can tell, is the steam options on the dryer side. You've got, you know, turbo steam or steam fresh, which helps if you're trying to do some kind of wrinkle release or just eliminate bacteria and get it really hot with steam. Now, the difference between this guy and this guy, they have all the same features. It's just a size difference. This has 5 cubic feet on the washer, where this one only has 4.5 cubic feet, and that's the main difference. These two models come in the two colors you see, white and dark. This model here comes in a third color, where it's more of a stainless steel. So first, let's start with the cons. I kind of hinted to what the cons are introducing this machine, and it's basically that you can't separate it. And if either breaks, unless you can have somebody repair it, you're gonna have to buy a whole new washer and dryer. Another con related to that is this is a big, heavy piece of machinery. You know, normally if you're moving a washer and dryer, you move one at a time and it breaks it up into two separate loads. However, with this guy, it's just one big clunky appliance that you have to move all at once. I'm sure you could somehow flip that into a pro, but it's something to think about. Another con related to this, you might move. Like, maybe this fits perfect here, but you move to another house where you're unable to have stackable washer and dryer because you don't have enough height. Well, normally if you have one that's stacked, you just move the washer over to the side and make it work and it's fine. However, with this, you're just gonna be SOL and having to figure out a different solution. Another con that I was actually kind of disappointed in with this washer and dryer that I didn't even realize was a con until I started researching it to make this video is a lot of the new washers out there have an auto dispense for the detergent. Basically, it's like a big reservoir where you can pour a lot of detergent in there, and then it'll go up to like 40 loads or something, to where it auto dispenses the amount of detergent it needs for one cycle, but can hold a ton of volume for a bunch of cycles. So like I said, I was actually kind of bummed out when I realized, oh, that's a feature and this one doesn't have it. It was a bummer. So it's something to definitely know and think of. Another thing that I'm not quite sure if I'd actually use, but I think is a great idea, is some of these newer washers have what's called an overnight cycle. Now, you're still gonna get a dryer, you're not gonna use your washer as a sole dryer, but the reason they call it an overnight cycle is because it can do both wash the outfit or clothes and dry them. And the idea is like, oh, you have an outfit, it's dirty, you'd like to wear it tomorrow, we'll throw it in the washing machine with an overnight cycle and it'll wash it like it normally does. But in order for it to dry, since it's not the setup to dry, it takes a really long time, way longer than a normal dryer, but you're gonna be sleeping, it's overnight, it has that full, you know, 8 hours to wash and dry, and that's why it's called an overnight cycle. But that would be convenient if you have a favorite outfit, you've already worn it, you've got something fun to do the next day and you want to wear that outfit again, you can just throw it in the washing machine at night, and when you wake up in the morning, it's ready to go. You don't have to transfer it from the washer to the dryer. I think that's pretty nifty and cool. It's a nice little feature, and this one does not have that. And the last con with this guy was the tech is a little bit janky. You know, I am a tech guy. I love technology. I've had the full smart home. Like, I get really involved into tech stuff. If you check out my other videos, you'll see I'm a pretty tech savvy person. With that being said, this was a pain in the butt to set up. It was not easy to follow and smooth like some of the other stuff I've used. I can see your average person trying to set up the Wi-Fi on this in terms of having it able to communicate with your phone through the app and struggling, getting discouraged and not actually end up using it. I think eventually LG will be able to fix that. And really what I think it is that they have one instructions for all different washer and dryers. And this washer and dryer has fewer buttons and is maybe cleaner and a different kind of interface. But because the instructions are generic or written for possibly a different machine, you get kind of stuck and have some issues with this guy. It's nothing you can't overcome. It just is very frustrating when you have to take time out of your day to figure something out that is designed and supposed to make it easier. Now, once you get past the setup process and once you learn how to use the app and whatnot, I would definitely say it's a pro. I didn't have that in my last washer and dryer, and it's something that I really, really like. A little bit more than I thought I actually would, which I'll explain here in a minute, and it's a great segue to get into the pros. So, on that note, a pro is, hey, you can connect it to your phone, and that's actually pretty nifty. There's a lot of features, bells and whistles you can do with it, but I think what most people actually utilize and will be functional for them is two things. One is, when your wash is done, you get a notification on your phone, which is really nice because then you're reminded, hey, go put it in the dryer. And when the dryer is done, same thing, you get a notification, and it's nice because you can think, okay, I need to go take them out of the dryer, otherwise my clothes will wrinkle. And in the past, I would just forget that I started a load and then come back, you know, later on that day or maybe even the next day, and it's like, oh no, my wet clothes have been sitting in the washer. If only you had a way to remind yourself. With a regular washer, you can just set an alarm on your phone, but this way you don't even have to think about it, and it never fails, because that's what I used to do, and a lot of times I would forget to set that alarm. Now, the other really nifty thing is, when your clothes are done drying, a lot of times I'm busy at that moment and I don't go take my clothes out and hang them up or fold them, which allows them to wrinkle. But what's really nifty is when you remember, oh yeah, my clothes, I'm gonna go do that, you know what? I don't even have to go to the washer, I can just open up my phone. So that's just a big feature to me. I can open up my phone, wrinkle release cycle, and then get a notification, hey, it's time to go hang your clothes, and that is just pretty helpful. Now, if you are tech savvy, there is a lot of cool features you can do with the app. There's a lot of cycles that you can download that have different, you know, features. But at the end of the day, it's a washing machine. I don't know how different and great those cycles are. I think it's a little bit of fluff, but every single manufacturer, I believe, does that. But, you know, you buy a washer and dryer, it has all these nifty features, but pretty much you do the same thing every time, run normal cycle or whatever cycle you like to run and normal dry. So it's not that great. I'm not going to get into the details of it because I don't really think it's something people will use. So the pros that are around the design is it saves space. You can actually see we have a shelf right there. And if we would have gotten a traditional stackable washer and dryer, it wouldn't actually fit in this space. So that was really nice that we were able to find one that would fit our space. And that's what I would say is the biggest function or best thing about this, is if you're really looking to be efficient and save space, this does it. Another advantage of this design is normally you have your controls here for your washer, and then the controls for your dryer up here, which is out of the line of sight with your eye, so it's harder to read, harder to use, especially if you're not a tall person. You're really going to be reaching up there, and it's a big inconvenience for some, and this completely eliminates that by putting all the controls together right here. And obviously beauty is in the eye of the beholder, but I think this is a really good sleek looking design. For me, that's a pro. They actually make different colors. They have a dark one, they have a light one that you're seeing here. And for the model that's actually bigger than this, it's basically got more capacity. I believe it's called like stainless steel, but it's a darker one. I actually think this is the worst looking model. I liked the darker one in this, which should be noted, at least at the time that I bought it, was $100 more. And my wife liked the lighter one though, so I'm not gonna even try to win that argument. So we got this one, and I think even the lighter white color, I mean, it looks great. It definitely looks better than my old washer and dryer, which was a Samsung. I'll throw a picture on there now. A couple other things is, you know, it's not super quiet, but it's quieter than my last washer and dryer, which is nice. I don't really have much to compare it to other than my last washer and dryer and this one. It's quieter than that one. I don't know if it's the quietest machine out there. And then the last pro, which is pretty obvious, is, you know, before I had top loaders, this is a front loader. It's a lot nicer to have a front loader. You just push it in, move it around. It was nicer than my last washer and dryer, and I do like the front loading idea and how it works. All right, so let's get to the good part of this video. Would I recommend it? Those features of having the overnight cycle or the reservoir that can hold a bunch of detergent so you don't have to pour it in each time. If that's something you want, then I wouldn't go with this. And if you're looking to get the most economic, cost-effective, cheaper washer and dryer, I don't think you should go with this because it's a washer and dryer. It's made to do one thing. You can find plenty of alternatives that are more cost effective. We just really liked the way it looked, and I also liked the fact that I could connect it to my phone. That was like the only thing that I was looking at the time. And again, like I said, I was kind of bummed out once I learned ignorance is bliss. I didn't know about that multi-cycle reservoir where you could hold a bunch of detergent. But, you know, not a big deal. First world problems. So it's a great washer and dryer. I would recommend it if you like the functionality and the design. And if not, hopefully this video helped you realize whether or not it would be a good choice for you. If you think I did a good job, got some value, the way you can let me know is just like, comment, or subscribe. And if you didn't, I mean, you can give me a thumbs down too. It's all good. Thanks for watching my video, and I'll see you guys next time.